I am Dr. Shanthi, a dentist by profession. Like any other doctor, I was busy with my family and my patients. I never dreamt to be an environmentalist or a waste warrior. But one incident has changed my life. It had forced me to come into the field of SWM, solid waste management. What is that one incident which changed me? One day, I was sitting in my balcony. I saw a waste picker with his auto who came to collect the garbage from our street. I saw him literally standing in between the auto in the waste and trying to segregate the high-value plastic, which will fetch him few rupees after selling. That sight had a huge impact on my mind, thinking about the plight of waste pickers and their families. Most of us hesitate to touch our waste. These people, the waste workers, are forced to live in that situation which is unhygienic and inhuman. The idea came from there to ensure better working conditions for these poor waste pickers. Thousands of tons of garbage goes to landfills every day. But I was not aware of the whole cycle of garbage. I think most of you are not aware. If I ask someone, do you know where your garbage goes? They either say to the dustbin or they say corporation takes it, but not aware beyond that. But I wanted to learn the cycle of garbage from the collection point to the end disposal. I literally followed the garbage auto. I saw that after collecting 1,000 households, it got shifted to a bigger vehicle called compactor. From there, the compactor went to the landfill. I literally went to the landfill. This is how most of the people dispose garbage. This is how most of the people dispose garbage. Why? This makes it convenient. They think these plastic covers will make their dustbins very clean. And they are unaware of the law of segregation and disposal. Their ignorance of where the destination for the mixed garbage makes them do this mistake. The mixed garbage will be collected like this. Either it will end up in landfills, or it is being burnt on our streets, or illegally dumped in the lakes. The people living around the landfill are in a miserable situation because of our irresponsible act. The rural areas chosen as landfills are deprived of clean air to breathe, pure drinking water, and a good soil for cultivation. If we think it's only rural areas which are suffering, we are wrong. If the underground water table is contaminated with the leachate from the landfill, we are using the same water. The soil polluted there is the soil used by rural people to grow the vegetables we get every day from. So you can think and imagine what are we drinking and what are we eating. So we are also the sufferers. The waste pickers working in this condition are continuously at the risk of injuries from the mixed garbage. This woman who lost her finger while picking the hazardous waste, broken bottles from the waste which we educated, mix and give. None of these pictures are from Google. They are the original, real pictures on ground taken by us. Who is responsible for this mess? Each one of us who is knowingly or unknowingly mixing the garbage and throwing, who is generating waste and not knowing where it is going, everyone is responsible for this. Is there a solution for this humongous problem? Yes. The solution for this is very simple. When people understand that 95% of the waste they generate is a resource. Typically, any household of four people will generate somewhere around 750 grams of waste. That's all. And out of that 750 grams, 60% of the waste is organic waste, 60%, which should get composted and reach the soil back, or can be converted into biogas and used, replace LPG. 35% of it is recyclable or non-recyclable plastics, but this can further be reduced by conscious use of disposables. So what is left? But this 35%, lot of livelihoods are depending on this waste, recycled waste. What is left is this 5%, which I call it as a reject waste, is actually garbage. But this can also be further reduced by using sustainable options like menstrual cups, cloth sanitary pads, cloth diapers, etc. But instead, today, unknowingly, we are considering the whole 100% as garbage and burdening the landfills, burdening the planet. After understanding the problem and solution, the first thing anyone should do is to change their habits. Consciously think, what am I doing? What am I generating? Is it mandatory? Can I avoid this? Just start thinking from now. After I change, it is not enough. It is not enough. This space is not enough. We need to spread the ripple. I felt this ripple cannot be spread by an individual. That's when it required a huge team. That's when I joined as a member of Solid Waste Management Roundtable. Solid Waste Management Roundtable has members from across city who strive for policy changes at city level. It's with the efforts of Solid Waste Management Roundtable that High Court has mandated the law that two bin, one bag is the way of segregation for a city of Bangalore. Swachhagraha is a campaign by SWMRT which speaks in detail from the basic to the end point of composting. Anyone who wants to learn composting can learn from there. Trashonomics is another wonderful campaign by us which aims at making children knowledgeable on waste management and the value of waste. Trash plus economics is trashonomics. So any school which wants to adopt, have session, can contact us for this. This is when I felt solid waste management is something which demands a full attention. It's not enough for me to do just as a volunteer for 1 or 2 hours when I have time with the clinic. I could not manage both. It demanded a dedicated time. That's when I had to close my clinic and practice and had to become a full-time volunteer waste warrior. So after the policy changes by SWMRT, I realized every policy change on the paper doesn't have value. It has to be implemented on the ground. The law is brought, but who will implement on the ground? Myself, with two of my friends, we have started awareness door to door, going to each house and telling people the importance of segregation. How can we stop waste going to landfill? But after 10 days, I saw it was a failure. When I came back to people, they were not segregating. The reason was the corporation autos which come to collect the garbage were not equipped to collect segregated waste in a segregated way. That's when I understood it's not at a citizen level alone, it involves involvement of corporation. That's when we met our zonal joint commissioner and requested him to make necessary changes by equipping the autos to collect in a segregated way, timely, regular collection, which helps people to follow the law. He made the necessary changes and we could see positive impact. That is when like-minded people joined me, thinking this is a cause which needs time and it's worth it. That's when we formed an organization called HSR Citizen Forum. But this team is not enough to reach 28,000 plus houses in my ward. So we approached schools. We involved school children, took workshops, conducted sessions for them, made them aware of the importance of segregation, and took them onto the roads for door-to-door campaign. Kids were very enthusiastic to participate, and involving kids is very important to ensure they grow up as responsible and active citizens for life. Then we met our resident welfare associations and ensured we could reach all the 28,000 houses door to door, giving the awareness. It was not an easy task. We spent considerable amount of time, especially on weekends on the ground, because that's when people are at home to listen to us. It was not an easy task because most of our team members were women who had responsibilities back home, but we achieved. But I felt giving awareness is one step, but sustainability of that initiative is a challenge. You move forward giving awareness to 30,000 people, and if we feel that it is stopped, no. You come back after 6 months to see everyone on square, everything on square one, back with mixed garbage. That is when we felt penalty drives continuously by the corporation is required. Again, penalizing the defaulters, we have insisted on corporation. By now they also felt citizen involvement really brings change. They started supporting us, and every day there's a penalty drive for everyone who refused to segregate. By then, we realized single-use plastics is a big hindrance. Any event, anywhere, disposable plastics is a big hindrance in the sustainability of solid waste management. We approached our elected representative, our MLA, and asked him, "Sir, can we have a plastic-free HSR layout?" He was shocked because it is not an easy decision for any elected representative to make. But he believed in our vision, and he agreed and waved off the flag for plastic ban. We spent again enough time for giving awareness to all the commercial establishments not to use plastic. Gave them considerable amount of time to change into sustainable alternatives. That is when we started penalizing shops for using plastics. Everyday penalty for the shops, seizing plastic and penalizing the defaulters. This is when these commercial establishments approached MLA, the elected representatives, seeking help to escape from penalty. We told him, "Sir, if you want this initiative to be successful, if you ever want HSR layout to be seen as a zero plastic ward, you cannot support them." He agreed in every gathering, every meeting, he would insist that he would not support the defaulters and he wants a successful plastic free HSR layout. This is another wonderful initiative. What made us think this leaf composting? We have wonderful trees around which shed leaves for a reason. I don't know how many of you are aware, trees shed leaves for a reason. But people think it is a burden. They sweep, make a heap, and they lit fire. This was a regular practice, which used to hurt us because it is wasting natural resource and also air pollution. That made us again go back to the municipal corporation and asked our joint commissioner, "Sir, we want leaf composting tanks in every park." Everyone, be it be elected representatives, be it be municipal authorities, they believed in us because this ask is a selfless ask for the benefit of the community. He ensured every park had a composting tank which would take tons of leaves which are around the park. It is a costless, just an effort of cow dung slurry which monthly twice our power karmikas would spray, which would turn into a rich manure. If any of you know the value of manure, this is a wonderful carbon which has to reach soil. From then, there is no burning of leaves in HSR. With plastic ban and segregation, we had reached 90% of success. Next what? That is when we felt we need to do something good, something more. We realized that birthday of our MLA is approaching. Usually, elected representatives celebrate their birthdays by giving food, by giving clothes. We asked him, why don't you take up one green initiative? He was like, okay. We made him distribute 100 home composting kits in the layout and 12 temple composting rings. People pray to God thinking that something good will happen to me. But after that, all that is considered waste. I don't want to know where it is going. But we change that. We get divine compost out of these temple rings. And all these 100 people started composting by knowing the value of waste. That had a very positive impact. After starting composting, we felt my 500 grams of composting doesn't solve much of it. I need to do something big. That prompted us to ask our MLA for the next birthday, 2017. We asked him, sir, why don't you donate lane composters? When I'm composting, I'm not still satisfied. I want to do a pilot of 45 houses in one lane composting in front of my house. Though shocked, he agreed because he believed in our vision. He donated 10 lane composting tanks of one lane as a pilot. This compost, where would it go? Bangalore is not a place where everyone will have a garden. Where would that compost reach? We noticed some waste place where people used to dump garbage. We cleaned it, we divided into patches, welcomed all those who are composting to grow their own vegetables. It is a wonderful feeling when people grow their own vegetables. If not everything what you eat, if not everything what you eat, some amount of what you eat, you can grow. So people started growing their own food. Then 2018, again, MLA's birthday is approaching. 3 months before, people started asking me, what is that we are asking this time? Everyone started becoming curious in the city, what is HSR doing for this year's birthday? And we went with a big project. It's a dream project for SWMRT and HSR Citizen Forum to have one spot learning for all the composting methods, biogas, everything at one spot. Any apartment, any RWA, any school comes there should go out with enough knowledge of composting, motivated to compost, grow their own food. So we went with a hesitation because this is a big project which needed a lot of funds. Our MLA, with the experience of these many years, he said, your wish, my command. I couldn't believe that it would be so easy and ask that would become a reality. Within 6 weeks, it was a roller coaster ride, but we made it successful. Swachhagraha Kalika Kendra. Kalika, thank you. Kalika in Kannada means learning. Swachhagraha is our campaign. Swachhagraha Kalika Kendra, a compost learning center, one of its kind in the country. So now people from different areas come there to learn composting, also growing. We have people to explain how to grow on their terrace, how to grow on their balconies. So, what I understood in my journey of 7 years is I need to dream, visualize the dream to be successful, passionately work, tirelessly work towards achieving that goal. And I am very determined not to give up whatever hurdles I face. I did face in my journey of 7 years, I did. I just showed you the clear path, which, but I did have hurdles. But nothing stopped me because my goal was very strong. I was very determined. And a good intention, believe me, will have every force on the universe to support and make it happen. For all those who feel, I don't have time. I am very busy with my work, with my school, with my college. I don't have time for all this. I request people to choose their limitations. If you don't have time, you can choose to change all by yourself. That's all. That doesn't need demand much time. Change all your habits. Consider your waste as a value. Compost your waste from today. Learn, Google. Compost your waste. Stop using single-use disposables. You carry a water bottle. What it takes for you to carry a water bottle? What it takes for you to eat with a hand? Why do you need a spoon? What it takes to drink the tender coconut without a straw? All these are habits which you can change. This doesn't demand any time. For people who have little more time, yes, this cause is something which is touching my heart, can contribute little more time by changing their neighborhood. If you're a college student, you can change your college premises, making it a zero plastic zone. If you're working in a workplace, you can change habits in your workplace. People drinking coffee, tea in paper cups, ask them to stop. Come back to the culture. It's not a rocket science. It's all what our grandparents followed. It is as simple. Let's get back to our culture of reuse. Disposables is not our culture at all. Let us get back to our culture and follow simple what our grandparents followed. Encourage your neighborhood. After this, if still people feel, no, I need something to do, become a leader. Believe me, there are people who are just looking at a leader to follow. You start something which you believe in, you start, and you will be followed by hundreds of people to support the cause. All that you need is belief that there is a need to change. There is a need to change. After you believe, make sure you change and spread the ripple. It is our responsibility, each one's responsibility, to leave a better, healthy space for the next generations to come. Let us be responsible, start from today. Thank you.